So here we have the Canon R6, and if you saw my initial video about this R6, you probably know that I wasn't a huge fan of this camera. Color temperature is not matching other Canon cameras, and the biggest was probably the autofocus. Someone is calling me. How dare you call me while I'm filming? I don't know, it's an unknown number. Should I answer it?
Yes.
Fraudulent activities under your social security number, and to talk to our representative, please press 1.
Yeah, let's do it.
Social Security Administration, how may I help you?
Hi, what's wrong? She hung up on me. Man, I was really hoping to get my identity stolen today. You know you're annoying when the scam callers hang up on you. But anyways, all my complaints are video focused complaints. And I think that's the issue, is because this camera really was designed with photography in mind first, right? But I am a video guy, so I was really reviewing this camera as a video camera. But now I just want to take a look at this as a photography camera. We went to go pick up that van all the way in Michigan, had a 2,500 mile road trip back, and the whole time I had this in photography mode. So let's go check out some of the photos we took. Come on, Sam. Let's go. What are you waiting for? And welcome to the van. We have Sam behind the camera.
Dude, I'm really straddling this tripod. I think I'm gonna have to take it to dinner after.
Yeah, nice steak dinner. Some of the very first shots we took with the R6 was for this thumbnail here, and this is just the plain JPEG straight out of camera. Look at how sharp this looks. Sam, you can see the photos through the iPad, right?
Yep.
All right. Oh, by the way, we have Skylum sponsoring today's episode, so we are going to be doing a giveaway with an iPad, 128 gig version, so you can kind of do something like this with your photos. Take a look at that photo right there. I mean, that's pretty sharp. Like, we've taken a lot of photos on the EOS R, but I swear this R6 looks a little bit crispier, a little bit cleaner than we were able to get with the R, don't you think?
Oh yeah.
I wonder why though, because the EOS R is a 30.3 megapixel full frame sensor, and the Canon R6 is 20 megapixels. So it actually has less resolution than the EOS R, but I feel like it just looks cleaner for some reason. So check out this photo with Nurk here, and definitely a decent amount of detail, and 20 megapixels is plenty, I think, for most cases. We can get in real close to some of the propellers. And we shoot a lot with the EOS R with the same lens, which is the 15-35 RF lens. Do you think the EOS R was this sharp?
I mean, I've taken some photos with the EOS R. I don't think I ever got it that sharp.
I wonder if it's a sensor, or maybe it's the way they process the JPEGs. I wonder. Next stop was Illinois, so let's cut to some footage from there.
Are you living in Chicago?
Yeah, I wish you were staying a few days to explore it a little bit more.
It does have a little bit of a New York vibe.
Hey, what's going on?
It's chilly tonight, but it's like a tolerable chilly. Uh-huh. Like a nice brisk walk in the park.
Here's the deal. I'll take a photo in every state we pass through.
Yeah.
All right.
A photo of us?
Yes. Yeah. A photo of us, or maybe just you. What's really interesting about Chicago is that their architecture, half of it is super old and half of it is super modern, huh?
Sorry, I'm spacing out. I'm so sorry.
Chicago's been great. The pizza's been great.
It's great. I wish you could stay longer.
So last time I was here for work, so I didn't really enjoy it nearly as much as I enjoyed it this time. So much better when you come here for fun. So in Chicago, we did some nighttime photography. This photo here was taken at 3200 ISO and looks pretty clean. So let's go ahead and take a look at the raw version of this. Again, 3200 ISO on here. And I kind of want to see how much info is in this raw image here. I'm going to go ahead and fix that white balance a little bit. Let's make it look a little bit less crazy warm. Let's put it right there. I want to see how much of the details I can pull out from the shadows. That's actually not bad, huh? Look at that jacket.
Oh man, you can see every stitch. That's amazing.
Yeah. If I bring up the shadows a little bit, I'm curious how much information I can kind of pull out of there for the jacket. But definitely not bad. 3200 ISO, you could definitely see a little bit of noise, but it's not bad, right? So pretty decent in low light, but aside from that, the IBIS was really helpful there as well. These are half second exposures. I have pretty shaky hands. Any other camera, the image would definitely come out looking pretty blurry. For me, I feel like I have to at least have it 1/50th of a second for it to come out looking at a decent sharpness. If you look closely, you could definitely see some motion blur here and there. But for the most part, that IBIS was definitely saving me. Without that IBIS, I would have been totally screwed. All right, so now we are in Iowa. Look at some of these sunsets here though. They look so good. I want to get a few self-timer photos right here of us on the van. The only thing is the dynamic range is pretty intense. Like the sunset looks so good all the way down here. You know, you get that red, blue, and orange up there. And the van's all the way down here in the dark. So I'm gonna try to shoot these right in the middle and hopefully there's enough detail in the RAWs to recover it.
That's pretty backlit. Let's try a few right here. This is looking pretty nice. Photo time.
Look at this. This actually looks like a Luminar sky replacement, but this is real. The sunsets are beautiful out here in the Midwest, huh? All right, so check out this photo right here. This is the JPEG. Sky's definitely really bright, and the van is in the shadow. A lot of dynamic range needed here. Here we go, and processed.
Woo!
Not bad, huh?
Okay, I thought it was gonna be like, oh yeah, that's good, but it's really, really good.
Yeah, so let me pull up Luminar. Let me show you the edit here. So like, the amount of detail there that was recovered for Carrie was pretty good. And the sky as well. And this wasn't sky replacement or anything either. It was more sky enhancer. So I just brought that sky in a little bit. Check this out. Boom. Before and after.
Gene, I think you just dropped something. My jaw, that's amazing.
I knew that we would be able to recover it to an extent, but I was definitely surprised at how much we were able to actually recover. We took a few more photos where it was pretty intense dynamic range. So I'm definitely happy with the amount of flexibility that we have with these RAW files. All right, now we're in Omaha, Nebraska. It's super windy out here. Check this out. It's such a challenge to just keep this thing in the air. Oh, gosh. Okay, a huge gust of wind came in. This thing came and whacked the microphone. This is a bad idea. I should stop flying this thing. And apparently, it's not just here that's windy. Back home, too, I guess. I just got this video message from Sam.
So we heard a noise outside, bro, and this happened. It's pretty windy outside, so I think the umbrella broke your table. Oh, no. It's okay. We'll clean it up.
Oh, man. I definitely should have rolled up that umbrella before we left. I found this random stranger to allow me to take some photos of him. Let me just like straighten this down. Like, it just wants to split in half. It wants to do this. I need to keep your beard together, so I think we just need to braid it together.
Hey, there we go. Much better. Much better. So, hello, strange man. What are you about to do?
I decorate myself with some beautiful foliage.
Who are your favorite?
So here I have the 24 to 70 Sigma f2.8. It's not a bad combination though, huh? Like, I like that shot right there. Like, I definitely love the Sigma lens. It's super sharp, but you can also kind of see that the bokeh is a little bit sharper and a little more intense, but overall, pretty solid looking image out of the R6. We had Max throw some leaves up in the air. I put the shutter on continuous and just held down that shutter. And here are the series of photos that we came out with. How do you like my braiding skills? I braided his
beard. Dude, he looks like a hipster Viking. It's awesome.
So these images are the RAWs that were edited, and I had the shutter speed up pretty high. So you can see every little detail in the leaves. I took a few shots in Colorado at our campsite, but we just passed through there real quick. Although Colorado looked amazing. We're definitely gonna have to do a road trip there one of these days. All right, we made it to Arches National Park in Utah.
We're here.
I know, it looks epic, huh?
Yeah, it's so beautiful.
It's way bigger than it looks like in the photos, huh?
Yeah, the arches themselves are huge.
Let's see if we can do something epic with this photo here. Let's go to landscapes. Autumn colors? Yeah, that looks pretty nice. Dramatic landscape. Oh, warm sunset. Let's start with autumn colors and just kind of tweak it a little bit. There was no sky there really. Dramatic sky one. Too much. Dramatic sky three. Oh man, look at that. That looks pretty sick. Is that cheating?
Well, it depends. You're not like lying to people.
I don't always tell people that I use sky replacement. I took this photo of Carrie and I sent it to her. I didn't tell her I use sky replacement. And then eventually she was like, oh yeah, huh? The sun doesn't set that direction. This is with sky replacement. And this is without. This is actually already with sky enhanced. So see how the AI sky enhancer is already up there? None and after. Canon just has really good colors, don't they?
Yeah, it looks epic.
But look at that. Before, after, man, I just feel like this is cheating. You know what would make me feel better is if we just go out, shoot a bunch of sunsets, just the sky, and then we use that sky and drop it into our own photos. Like the top third of this photo, I didn't take that photo. So I feel like I can't take credit for this image. But if we went out and snapped a bunch of sunsets and then we mixed it, then it's like
mixing two of your own photos. But I didn't take that sky, so I feel like I'm stealing. But it looks so good, and it's so easy to do.
I feel like this is where the Viking hipster will live.
By the way, the software I'm using is called Luminar 4. I like it because you can do all kinds of effects to it really fast and really easy. Literally, those sky replacements is like one click, and it's made by our sponsor, Skylum. But they aren't sponsoring this video for Luminar 4. They're sponsoring it for their upcoming software that I haven't actually seen or tested yet. I'm very excited about it. It's called Luminar AI, and it does share a lot of the characteristics and abilities you can do with Luminar 4, which is what I've been using primarily. But there's a whole lot of under the hood improvements, and it should also be faster and more accelerated to work with more of the modern chips. And it's very cool because it's very quick and easy to get all kinds of different looks. So I usually just start by looking at the looks on here, finding something that looks somewhat along the lines of what I'm going for. But this is really just a starting point. At this point, I can go in and make the adjustments that I typically would make, and you fine tune everything. But I do like the convenience of being able to just say, I want this kind of look, pop it on, try it out, and then go make adjustments from there, opposed to just starting completely from scratch every single time. They're telling me that every time you open up an image in Luminar AI, it's going to analyze the image, get an idea of what that image is, and then suggest templates to you, which is kind of like these looks, kind of like filters that you can apply, get in that ballpark, and then fine tune all your adjustments.
Definitely a great way to up your Instagram game.
Yeah, right? So I'm definitely excited for what Luminar AI has to offer. It's supposed to be coming out this holiday season. I'll throw a link down there in the description with some more info. I wonder if the sky replacement will also recognize these holes.
I would be very impressed if it did. I am gonna say no though.
Dramatic Sky 4. Oh hey, snap, it did. I'm gonna soften up
the... I'm not too crazy about this sky. Can we change it to something a little bit more, I don't know.
How about Galaxy?
Now we're cooking with bacon.
But before we do that, let's see if there's even actually a sky there. Oh, there actually is a little bit there. Check that out. Bring down the whites a little bit. Actually, we could just go into here, enhance the sky, and see what we get. Oh yeah, there's a little bit there. It was mostly cloudy, but...
Oh, snap. Accent. That actually looks really good.
Yeah, so, man, see, we don't always have to cheat with sky replacement.
Work with what you have, I guess.
I actually had a lot of fun being in photographer mode, you know, because I'm always video mode, but like, you know, you kind of like change your mentality a little bit. Now, I want to say if you're purely focused on photography, the R6 might be the best photography camera I've ever used so far. Now, I haven't really used the R5 in photography mode very much, but R6, I'm definitely loving the images out of here. And even though it doesn't have as high of a megapixel count than the EOS R or the R5, the colors are rich and nice. There's a lot of dynamic range and flexibility. In the IBIS though, especially when you have to shoot with that extended shutter, loving it.
Giveaway, man, tell us the details.
Well, it's the iPad.
What is that pose?
Oh, I was gonna put an iPad.
There's nothing there.
You get it by commenting down your favorite song.
Why do you look so confused?
I didn't have enough time to practice.
Comment down below your favorite song and you have a chance to win. I guess that's what's going on.
I think so.
Yeah, okay, cool. That works for me.
Yeah.
Yay.
Giveaway boy out. Oh, no, you're supposed to leave. You're supposed to stay over there.
So I've been informed that this video is already really long, so let's try to wrap it up. Nevada, next state, early in the morning. And of course, the dynamic range comes in nicely here. We have the bright sky, but still the city itself hasn't been lit up yet. And then we stop by the seven arch colors, rock something. I don't know what it's called. Usually it's pretty crowded there, but this was like 6:30 a.m. So if you want to get nice empty photos, go early. And of course, we have colorful rocks with colorful Canon colors. You can't go wrong. And finally, we have made it back here to California with our new baby. But yeah, overall, as a photography camera, I think you're gonna get great images. But if I had to choose between the EOS R or R6 strictly for photography, I would probably still go for the R6, even though we have slightly less resolution. I'm really digging the IBIS in there. I feel like that really makes a difference when you try to extend out your shutter speed a bit. And I also like how many buttons and switches and dials there are. We get our joystick back and we just have a few extra buttons here on the R6 and we have a dial.
Would I buy this camera? Not really, because I'm a video guy. So I really care about the video features. The autofocus in the video side of things just hasn't been up to par of where I need it to be. I shot about 3 or 4 vlogs on the R6, and every one of those vlogs, I want to say there was a half dozen comments in there just saying, what's wrong with the autofocus? So it is something that is being noticed on the other side of the screen for video. But when it comes to photography, the autofocus, no problems. Anyways, let's wrap this up by reading a few comments from my last video where we put our RED camera on an FPV drone. Oh man, I know what you're buying next. He was right on that one. Yeah, I immediately went out and got this thing right here. This thing's pretty fun. Nick says, please shoot a whole video only using a drone. Hey, I'll take any excuse to fly this thing. I've been addicted to flying FPV drones. Sam will take over the comments.
But I don't wanna.
Please do it.
Let's read the comments. Mr. Marble says, this video title should be how to fly your money at 100 miles per hour.
Flying that RED was kind of crazy, huh?
Alex W says, this is incredible to see this collab. Never thought I'd see Nurk and Potato Jet together.
Yeah, Nurk's awesome, man.
Yeah, dude.
I wish he lived closer to Los Angeles and we'll hang out all the time.
Yeah, he's a super funny dude. Ryan Ammer says, surely this can't go well. Edit, it went pretty well. Yeah, because Nurk was flying it.
I know, right? If I were to fly that thing, it would have definitely gone wrong.
Statement Prod says, Nurk is very casual about putting the RED camera on the FPV.
Yeah, he's kind of crazy, huh?
Yeah.
I don't know how he just casually flies around with like at least $30,000 worth of stuff. Watch this. Woo! And just free fall. Woo-hoo-hoo! Oh my God, this thing freaks me out so much. I love it. Dude, one of the craziest things about FPV drones is you just shoot up real fast and just free fall. Woo! And catch. You don't do that with a DJI drone.
Longtime fan of Nurk. Really happy to see this collaboration.
Me too.
It was pretty sick.
Oh.
All right, we're done.
All right, stop. We're done. Yeah, we're done. See you guys later.